bansang Oman na po. Kumusta po kayo? Isa na naman pong mapagpalang araw sa ating lahat. And sa lahat ng mga manggagawang Pinoy, sa gitnang silangan, o kahit nasaan man kayo sa panig ng mundo. So yesterday, during the press briefing sa laging handa doon sa Pilipinas, Secretary Belo, pinabanggit siya na kailangan pag-submit ng OFW ng kanilang information bago sila lumipad papuntang Pilipinas. So sinasabi nga niya na may bagong protocol yung Interagency Task Force para sa mga returning OFW.
Pero gusto kong iparating laki sa lahat ng ating mga kababayan, no, na under the new protocols of the Interagency Task Force, yung mga OFW na babalik sa ating bansa, before they leave the country of origin, they will notify us 5 days before their departure, so that when we get their names, their skills, and their final destination, ipaparating natin sa mga local government units, so that when they arrive here, immediately they will be tested, yung PCR. So, in a period of 1 to 3 days, malalaman natin kung negative o positive yung OFW. Ngayon, kung negative, we now, as per arrangement, we will now allow them to go home to their final place of destination. Kasi alam na ng mga local government units kung saan sila tutuloy, na darating sila at napaghanda na rin sila.
So today, DOLE have released an information about the tracking system, or the so-called OFW Assistance Information System, with acronym na OASIS. Napakaganda, no, ang acronym niya, no, OASIS. The locator will facilitate an orderly and smooth repatriation and assistance to the huge number of returning OFW. So ayun nga. So through the system, the government can track the whereabouts of our returning OFWs and provide them prompt assistance and relief upon their return to the country. And then, meron din dito sa description, the system will help DOLE identify and classify arriving OFWs in a number of ways to facilitate organized arrival of at the airport, efficient swab testing, and rapid pickup and transport to their respective hotels and homes and other necessary process. So, ayan, So, to be tracked, OFWs bound for home are requested to register online with OASIS through oasis.oa.gov.ph. So ayan po yung link. Ayan. Once there, they need to click register and fill out the form by providing appropriate data and information. So but anyway, but before we go further, no, kung bago lang po kayo sa aking channel, o kaya napadaan lang po kayo rito, mag-click naman po yung subscribe button. And if you want to get notified pag may bago kaming video ilalabas, click the bell button para agad-agad ninyo makita kung may mga ipopost kaming videos. Okay, let's see. Let's check the tracking system or the OASIS. Once you enter the URL, oasis.oa.gov.ph, you will be prompted to select language. It's either Filipino or English. But then, sige, let's see. Dito naman tayo sa abroad. Let's go for the English. Yan. So this is the system, this is the front page of the system, or this is the landing page, or the home page, or whatsoever. It is the initiative of the DOLE, OWA, tsaka POEA. So OFW Assistance Information System. The OASIS is an online platform intended to facilitate better service delivery to overseas Filipino workers. By registering in OASIS, you are providing necessary information to DOLE, POLO, OWA, and POEA that will enable them to respond to your concern and provide appropriate services in the view of COVID-19 pandemic, such as repatriation, testing, quarantine, and transportation. All information you will provide will be used in accordance with the Data Privacy Act of 2012. So, ayan po, if you are hesitant to enter your information as OFW, passport information, you are assured that will be used accordance with the Data Privacy Act of 2012. So, yan. Once you register, you will receive acknowledgement email confirming your registration and link to provide your current information. So, let's go. Let's try to register. register. Again. So let's just fill up this one. Na talaga ngayon ng mga social media. Cellphone number. Now, this is the problem. I don't know. But anyway, it's not mandatory. I have a phone number in the Philippines, 0945-338-4903. Yeah. It's a good thing na may roaming ako. May existing roaming ako. Of course, yung email ninyo. Yeah. Region. Ito, kung saan kayo pupunta. It's ako. Sa, let's say for example, I'm going to NCR, yes, province, Metro Manila, municipality, something is wrong. Bakit yung municipality natin, NCR, yan. Just choose the NCR, whatever. Barangay. Nature of work. Yan. So, it's either land-based or sea-based. Occupation. Internet ninja. Yan. So, country or flag of vessel of seafarer. Yan. Para lang kung sa seafarer. Name of employer. Yan na. Company abroad. Put there. Tapos yung address Muscat name of foreign, oh yeah, ito na yung recruitment, so ayan na, name of foreign recruitment agency, lagay nyo na yan yung agency ninyo, yung existing agency ninyo. Tapos ito, recruitment planning agency. Ito yung recruitment agency niyo sa Pilipinas. Ano nga ba? Oh, ano ko? Agency ko. I forgot. I think I recruit or whatsoever. I forgot. Sorry na lang. Okay. Ito, current employment status. On vacation. Contact. Okay. Put your emergency contact. 0945-338-4903. Okay, relationship, parents, ayan, specific need, ayan, travel, ayan. So ito no, specific needs, lalong-lalo na yung mga may family, o kaya may mga kasamang matatanda at saka buntis, ayan. So for me, let's say for example, I'm traveling with child, infant. Ito na, nature of repatriation. Ayan, on expense. Okay, on expense. So, yung airline ticket ninyo, you will provide that. Yeah, I can provide that later on because it's not mandatory. Yes, then, yeah. Okay. Then, of course, upload your IDs. What is one? Passport. Let's see. Passport. Do I have passport? Baby visa. Yeah, I have there. Okay, upload your passport. Then after that, after yung ma-fill up lahat ng mga ano, ng mga fields na po, just click submit. Where's the email? Where is the email? There. And make sure that you have the email address para makita nyo yung registration confirmation ninyo. Then just click submit. Yeah. So, ayan, naghanap siya, current of country of work, ayan, country of work, Oman, yes, then click submit, kailan ang arrival ninyo, hinahanap niya, yung arrival, yes, August, let's say, for example, August 08, 20. Arrival 5 p.m. Then click submit. Yes. Once you click the submit button, you will be prompted with this message. record added successfully. So ayan po ano, so after your registration, you will receive an acknowledgement email confirming your registration and link to update your current information. So ayan lamang po ano. Then again, ulitin ko yung link ng OFW Assistance Information System is oasis.owa.gov.ph. Just visit that link and register so that they will have your information at para ma-inform na yung LGUs ninyo bago pa man kayo dumating, so that they can roll the ano, red carpet na dadaanan ng OFW pagdating sa Pilipinas. So yun lamang po ano. So meron kayong mga katanungan, I will try to answer them. If you have comment, I will read them. If you like this video, click thumbs up. Then if you love it, just subscribe, share. Maraming salamat sa panonood. Stay safe. And of course, God bless everyone. Thank you.